So if you prefer to use column view in Finder like I do, then you probably deal a lot with the sizes of the columns. You know that you can click and drag the line between columns to grow it or shrink it. But there's some other things that you can do as well. For instance, if you have a long file name like this one in here, you can see you don't see the whole file name. It would be nice to be able to expand it to so you can see the whole thing. And you can drag and keep dragging until you get the entire thing. But you can also do something called right sizing the column. All you need to do is double click on the line and the column will automatically expand to be the perfect width for the longest file name in that column. And it only affects that one column. And it works the other way too. So if you have a really wide column here and I double click on the divider, it will shrink it so that just the perfect size to contain the longest name. Now you get more options if you control click on the line. So I'm going to control click on the line here and you see I get three options. I can right size this column, which is the same thing as double clicking on it. I can right size all the columns individually. So if I select that, it will right size everything. So let me shrink that one and shrink this one. Actually, let me grow that one there. And I'm going to do that and it right sizes this column and this column so everything fits. And the last option is to do it equally. So it's going to take the longest one and use that for the exact same size for all columns. Now none of this has any effect on future Finder windows. So if I say new Finder window and it opens up, you can see that that column is back to that default size there. It doesn't care that I changed the column size for those exact same folders here. In order to set a new default, you need to hold the Option key down as you drag. So I'm going to hold the Option key down and it sets a default for all columns. So you can see both columns are expanding and shrinking as I move my cursor. And whatever I leave it at, so if I leave it there, say, and I create a new Finder window, you can see the new Finder window has the same column width.